Thank you guys for coming out. Mike, you got us together. What did you get us together for here today?
Yeah, I mean, I think there's a question that's been plaguing the cornhole world for a while now. I mean, what the f*** is a carpet bag?
Carpet bags are, this is the future of cornhole, is a carpet bag. I throw them because it gets my opponent to think more than anything. I like playing that dirty game more than just the bag race game.
Every kid wants to do the carpet bag thing now. I mean, before it was nobody wanted to go down that path, but every kid you see come out, they're 14 years old and they're rolling bags over every freaking thing there is.
So I think this is one of the most talked about carpet bags out there right now, just because there's been so many wins by the guys like Creekill and the Foremans on the circuit right now. So this is a BG Viking. That's the fast side of the Viking. See, that's a real tacky carpet feel of a bag, smaller template. You know, what do you think about the fill? Like, what's used in a Viking, since you know these fills so much?
I mean, they're round more than flat, because the flat ones are gonna just lay the bag out, but they get the bag to do those exact things. Gets them to flop, roll, cut.
Makes them more bouncy.
Yeah, most definitely.
Carpet material can't be printed on or sublimated or anything like that, so you typically see like the design on the fast side of a bag. So the next one's like a wizard. So for instance, we have a Dirty Bags version of a BG Wizard. And obviously, you know, they offer their Wizard, their Viking, and all kinds of different designs, but we've worked with them to come up with our own kind of lineup of their covered bags. So you can see the fast side on this guy, which is a real fast material, and a much, I wouldn't say much quicker carpet than the Viking, but it is a little quicker than a Viking bag. But kind of like you alluded to earlier, like it seems to have that same feel and the poppiness, as you're calling it, that, as the Viking would do. So it'll behave similar to a Viking, would you say? Or is it not as easy to perform, you know, the shots that these guys are hitting with the rolls and the flops? And
yeah, it plays almost identical, just a little bit faster on that carpet side, so you don't really got to put some arm into it, opposed to like the Viking.
And then we have a new bag that came out from All Cornhole, called the Shag Attack. This was their first kind of intro into the carpet bag market, and it definitely has a different feel than, for example, the ones that we have out here today. Although, if you compare a Wizard fast side to a Shag Attack fast side, it's the same material, right? So the biggest difference is probably sizing, the volume of the bag, as far as the fill, and then obviously the carpet material. I don't know, between these two materials, what do you think the differences are in terms of playability and stuff?
This one probably doesn't kick on you as much. It's a little bit looser, it feels like. It kind of flattens out when you throw the bag, so you don't have to have it exactly flat when you throw it.
We got some of the original carpets, and I know you've talked to me about this before, something like back in the day, 4 or 5 years ago when we got started, Reynolds was already doing a carpet bag and it hadn't really caught on, but Tim's told me a number of times with the Advantage bags, that these were the perfect bags to learn to throw a flat bag on.
Oh yeah.
And why do you say that?
Because if you don't, they're gonna go right off the board. Yeah. People get so mad at them. I mean, you don't throw that bag flat, it's going right off.
Meaning side to side?
Side to side. It won't go deep. It'll cut right off the board. Right, left. That bag right there is, you gotta tell your teammate, hey, just flip it over to fast side and just stay right there and switch oleos.
That's what he'd tell me to do if I played with him on those.
I played with these bags when Mike first got them. And they weren't as kicky, but the feel, I mean, this is, what, 4 or 5 year old feel. The feel is so different now than it was then. But I mean, I played these bags for a long time when nobody wanted to play them, because everybody was just playing the fast bag.
Back then, 4 or 5 years ago, everybody kind of got into the race game, right? Everybody just threw a fast, floppy, loose bag, and that was the thing, right? You didn't really have to throw it flat, spin it, or anything like that. And one of the originators of that bag was Matty King, right? He came up with that really loose, floppy bag. And to show you how much the game has evolved and changed, I mean, when you look at a Matty King bag now, what is he primarily making? A carpet bag, right? So you got a bag like a Beast Mode that he's got out there, and and kind of what we've been talking about. It's a carpet bag, and that's probably that, along with his Double Dragon, is his kind of go-to bag. He obviously sells some fast floppy bags as well, but I think the game has changed so much in the last few years with all the new techniques and new styles and new throws that I think we're seeing every manufacturer move into that market of a carpet bag. So
I started out with Game Changers, and then I got beat up by a person throwing Reynolds. And that's where I wanted to throw him. I wanted to learn that roll shot.
Yeah. So I think what would be cool is to get a sampling of all these bags and see how they all kind of behave on the board, and have some of you guys that do know how to throw these flop shots and roll shots, and show us guys how that's done, and show how each one of these different bags performs. And we have some extra local pros that can kind of help us out. And let's do it. All right, so Double Dragon's coming up next.
I threw those earlier.
Extra blocker. Dude, look at that roll shot.
Yeah.
That thing's tacky.
Oh, that one.
That was ready to go.
That even went over
that.
That
still rolled.
Yeah, over that one. That's cool.
So, I mean, a traditional player, or like us old school guys, we would go airmail, right? I mean, these guys are just flopping them over the top.
Every one of those stayed on.
All right, so we got the BG Vikings up next, one of the more popular carpet. These are real tacky. Yeah.
So it's just like.
So if you back, look at that.
That's it, right? And
if you back
still
load
in front.
It.
And it just like piles it up.
All right, so the Warlock, little hybrid carpet.
I haven't thrown this one yet.
A little bit quicker.
That looks like that right there.
Look at that. Look at that roll.
The tilt wheel. I'm gonna call that one the tilt wheel.
Tilt wheel?
Yeah.
Nasty.
I mean,
that's a nasty cutter. All right, some old school carpet bags, the pro advantage right here.
This is the first carpet bag I ever threw.
Whew, those things skip.
And more like, they like skip / hop.
Yeah. All right, the new carpet bag by all Cornhole, the Shag Attack.
Shag Attack.
Cool.
I think it's
Teghan can
think
roll
it rolls.
Anything.
I think it rolls. Yeah.
Look at this. Look at that backloaded bag.
Crushed it.
I guess we should
and
take back.
And it just goes right through stuff.
We should take back anything we said about that not flopping. I mean,
right?
Perfect example of a carpet bag just flopping and rolling.
That was excellent.
That was incredible.
At the speed at which it flips over, it's probably not.
One of the unique things about the Shag Attack is they send those broken in, like they're pre-washed.
You get them broken in?
They're already broken in by the time you get them. There's no break-in period on those bags. The Beast Mode's coming up. A Matty King special.
Skipper. Dang.
There's that all flop.
Right. That one just crawled over two bags.
Thing, yeah.
It's like, all right.
We got a problem.
I'll go in.
We got some good looking wizards down there.
Those are my favorite ones. Oh.
Man, look at that. Okay.
Dang it. That looks awesome. Look at this. There we go.
Wow.
I think they.
I call it my favorite for a reason.
They passed the test.
Dude, that. That was my favorite bag.
The wizards are wizard four bagging.
Four flop shots. Perfect flop shots.
Sheesh.
New bag from, so one of Ultra's first carpet bags out. They just came out with the I'm not sure the naming, but they got the Widow carpet bag and they got the Viper version.
That's the Viper one.
This is the Widow one. Yeah, this is the Widow one. Widow R. Look at that flopper.
Flippy floppy. That was a skipper.
All right, let's throw some cut shots and see if we can get around the outside of some blocker bags rather than going over them. Let's see how these carpet bags react. So we're gonna set up some blocks, left side of the hole, almost right down the middle.
Tilt down for that one.
There it is.
Oh, that's it right there.
That's
okay,
the cut shot
exactly
right there.
That's a perfect cut
shot. So that just gripped and turned, right?
I mean, he hit down the 3/4 of the way down
right.
And it just slid right in.
And it just takes a hard left.
So like if I'm going for a cut, I'm really just trying to hit the spot on the board that I'm trying to aim for. So it's not so much like changing your mechanics. It's more like hitting the spot and just slightly tilting your bag. Like, you don't have to do too much.
All right. Tyler, where on the board are you trying to hit? Like, if you were, is it like here, here?
It kind of depends on the bag I'm throwing.
Okay.
But I'm realistically just trying to hit just to the right of the bag.
Like, so you're going to hit further up here?
Down
yeah,
a little bit.
Yeah, like okay. Kind of down a little bit, but like still pretty close to that bag.
Okay.
So then it like can at least stay down the middle.
Right. So you can see that bag. It's got the tilt, right? It's got that right to left tilt. There it is.
Like that.
Perfect.
Oh, yeah, that's
perfect.
A perfect example of it.
Beautiful.
Yeah, there it is. Just perfect.
Yeah.
It even stayed flat. That
but he stays skiing, but it still jumps a little bit, right? Yeah, that tackiness lets him bounce up. And that's what you see like a guy like Creek Killer or Foreman do a lot of.
The lower.
Because this is the way I normally hold a bag, dude. For slips, I just hold it just like this right here low, like that. That's it. Okay, I don't have any other kind of grip.
So take your thumb.
Yep. Oh, you can do that, pinch it?
Okay. More on the bag.
Like that?
There you go.
Right there. When I'm out, it's going to be like this? Or like that?
Kind of want to just keep your wrist straight.
Yeah.
And you kind of want to grab more. And when you throw it, see where the ass end is already?
It is like that.
Yep.
Okay. And then like fast rotation, you think?
I mean, the less rotation, the more friction on the board, and that's what gets it.
Less rotation. All right. Oh, okay. It did flip. That does make a lot of sense. All right. Like that, right? But when I let it go, you want to do like that. That's how it should look?
More or less, yeah.
That's not cool.
It's not easy.
Heck no, it isn't.
I've had like 20 people try to show me how to throw that freaking bag.
Learning the roll bags is the most frustrating things in the game.
I think at least I'll get one and I'm just walking away.
It's insane.
I'm throwing it too hard.
When you come down,
mm-hmm.
you're dropping your bag and see where your bag is like
yeah.
this.
Yeah.
Try to keep it more flat.
Oh, keep it flat. Okay. This down here. All right. Like that?
Yeah.
I know. I guess. Well,
yeah, the more the bag flat and in your hand, per se, when you're coming back.
Okay. Cool. Okay. Let's see. Oh, dragon bag's right here. This would be a good one. Like that. Yeah! Oh! Okay, that's the only roll shot I'm ever doing. That's it.
Hey, what did you do? What did you do different there, Dan?
What did I do different? Yeah, I grabbed the bag completely different than I normally do.
Really?
Yeah. Dirty.
Let's hear it.
Tim told me to grab it like this. I have a loose grip like this. That's it. I don't grab it and not like mess around.
So what did you change for the flop shot?
Flipped it over to the carpet side, and you told me to grab more of it.
So you're pinching the bag.
I pinched it in. I never grab it like that ever.
Right.
And you said,
so it's almost like, obviously, that's the butterfly grip that everybody's familiar with.
Okay, that's it, yeah.
Right.
And then come up, keep my wrist like that. But when I was missing earlier, he saw that. He said, do that.
Okay.
From start to finish. And then just let it go. And slower rotation. He said, it's like, has it more.
Just let it go?
Yeah, slower rotation has more friction, which makes sense because it's going to skip and get the bounce.
Yeah, yeah.
And it looked like it worked.
Yeah, so I mean, I think we got a good little rundown of carpet bags and what they are and how some of these pros can throw them. I don't think they're the magic pill for some of us guys. I mean, it's not like you just buy a carpet bag and all of a sudden you can start throwing those shots. It certainly takes some work, but I think we've got some education on how to do it.
Yeah, I'm definitely way more wiser on these bags, and I'm actually gonna start throwing them and I'll try them. I mean, I got one roll shot. I mean, it feels completely foreign to me, but.
If you haven't already, please subscribe to this channel. Thank you for watching on Cornhole Network.